Comment territorialiser les ODD ou
How do we
comment faire que ces
territorialize
ODD,
SDGs?
Objectifs
How do we make sure that SDGs, the Global Sustainable Development Goals, make sense for a given territory and territorial project? As of 2015, we have 17 Sustainable Development Goals. Truth be said, in the territories, we sometimes feel it's very far-fetched, it's coming from the top, and it's not really our business. But in the territories, we are lucky that we have a history with important international commitments for sustainable development. In Rio, in 1992, the first large conference was held, the Earth Summit, on awareness of the interdependence between demographic, social, environmental, climate, and many other issues. Now, this growing awareness on the global level led to a declaration known as the Rio Declaration. The declaration was about saying, it's time we did something. We need to do something for the 21st century, became Agenda 21, the Global Agenda 21. Which was then adopted in all the fields and all the countries. Interestingly, for Agenda 21, the approach consisted in admitting we were becoming aware on the international level of how interdependent environmental, social, economic issues were. Although we knew that when we tried to act above the international level, we will act in a sectorial way. That's precisely what happened with the Protocol on Climate and the one on biodiversity. Acting in complexity created by all the connections, the interdependent fields can only be achieved on the territorial level. The 1992 Rio Declaration contained the so-called 21 local agendas. If anyone wants to act in favor of sustainable development, taking all the connections in consideration, it can only happen locally. Ever since 1992, the territories have been encouraged to get hold of the main challenges and to see how all the players on the territories, depending on their history and their specific features, can take action. In France, it took very little time for the idea to sink in, although all countries have been encouraged to do so ever since 1992. It became part of the local community landscapes in the years 2000. At the time, local agendas 21 were blooming. It is one of the most accomplished processes to manage a territorial sustainable development project successfully. The project tells us where we're going. All five aims were contained in the National Reference Framework. It also determines how we're going there. We have a toolbox with method elements such as governance, citizens' participation assessment, etc. And these elements have been manipulated on the territories. In a nutshell, the Gironde department embarked in Agenda 21 in 2004. It moderates a network with all the local authorities in Agenda 21. There are 70 of those in the Gironde department. And for the last 13, 14 years, we have been learning together to practice sustainable development in the framework of strategic projects in sustainable development territorial projects. What is interesting is in what is happening with the 17 Sustainable Development Goals adopted in 2015, is that they remind us of the state of emergency. Roughly speaking, it's a good thing. In 1992, we thought, oh my God, we have problems, we need to act for the 21st century. Nowadays, all the states, all 194 countries which signed the 17 goals and the 169 targets to be reached before 2030 are saying, hey, we need to wake up. If we wait until the end of the 21st century before we act, it will be too late. So it shouldn't be Agenda 21, it should be Agenda 2030. Paying attention to the emergencies, revising the ambition and everything that caused territorial projects, Agendas 21 and the like, got lost. Merely becoming a list of actions. People said, oh, on the subject of biodiversity, I'm going to do this, on solidarity, I'm going to do that. But in the end, we forgot how one should act to meet challenges. And so the SDGs and Agenda 2030 are saying, you have all the raw material, you know how to work for sustainable development in a territorial project. So now we need to give feedback regarding the impact of the SDGs. The situation is urgent, it's serious. The situation can be serious locally, although we don't feel it so much in France. Life is rather good in France. But also globally and locally, the situation is serious. Nicolas Hulot, during the last summit meeting for the climate, was quoted as saying, for the first time, we have no choice. Either we succeed together or we fail together. We have no options. We're talking about the planet, the planet's future. There are impacts. We talk about the climate and about solidarity and the connection between the two, about biodiversity and migrants. We talk about the world in which we live today. We talk about awareness of the complexity, awareness of the interconnections and the links between things. We talk about our capacity to act. It is something we have learned with territorial sustainable development projects. We have the capacity to act. Technical and operational challenges are not the real issue here. The real question is, are we really going for it? So what we do now is work on facing emergencies. We work on transformation, not just continued improvement. It's not about doing something less worse or to have something that we can show in the window, gambling in the SDG lottery. For SDG 12, I do this, I take this action. No, the real matter is how to act on a level that matches the challenges, meaning that the reference framework we had with Agenda 21, the assessment set of references we had with Agenda 21, we need to lay on the table again. We have to look at the compass and understand how we should act with all 17 goals, how to revise our methods, especially when everybody's participating. That's absolutely crucial. But on top of continued improvement, there is also innovation, transformation, and the fact that we shouldn't fear dealing with breakthrough transformation. There is an SDG summary stating zero poverty, zero hunger, zero carbon. Okay, let's implement territorial projects, the aims of which will be zero poverty, zero hunger, zero carbon. No, not a few less poor people, that's a no-go. There comes a stage when we need to upturn the table and do it together to act on the right level to face the challenges. That is the real challenge. The transitions we're experiencing are inevitable. They're not an option. They're inevitable. It's happening. We're right in the middle of it. However, justice seems to be an option. For a player on the territories, resolutions and actions will strive to make inclusion and social and environmental justice accessible to all. That is our mission. We will target what is known as co-responsibility or accountability. There is no challenge on which one player has control alone. We should all wonder about our part in reaching those objectives. How we can fulfill 100% of our part, the part we're supposed to play. How we help those who have a part to play the right part. What does it mean to create a system of co-accountability which really matches the stakes? That's what I'm calling for. It's the local 2030 agenda. That's what we really need to work on. We have lots of knowledge and tools to do it.
On a énormément d'acquis et d'outils pour le faire.